New Year's morning. We hope you'll set the alarm, shake off cobwebs, and join us for a special 90-minute bowl edition of College Game Day from South Beach in Miami Beach, presented by Outback. Special start time on Monday, 9:30 Eastern time. We go 90 minutes, leading right up into the Capital One Bowl Week continuation with the Outback Bowl. The Gamecocks will have to find ways to score without Derek Watson against the Ohio State Buckeyes at the 11 a.m. Monday on ESPN. Bowl Week continues with Nebraska and Northwestern. Tomorrow night, 8 o'clock Eastern time, the Alamo Bowl. The biggest mismatch on paper of the bowls. Nebraska is a big favorite over Northwestern, but a lot of people looking at this game saying Northwestern has a great chance because they have an offensive style that's very difficult for Nebraska to defend. Do you buy it?
Well, you know, we've talked about underdogs. So we've talked about being unfamiliar with the style of play, and that helps Northwestern in this ballgame. Yeah, I buy the fact that Northwestern can move the ball against Nebraska. We've seen Nebraska give up yardage and some points this season. The real question is, can Northwestern handle the power game that Nebraska will bring? Yeah, the option is there, but Chris, I really think you're going to see them hammer them with that big back coming through.
Well, I think to also try to draw them in there to defend the run and throw the ball. I think you could see Nebraska get a bowl game with relatively nothing to lose, perhaps try to open things up and catch Northwestern napping and connect on a few passes as well.
That's right. They have a tendency to do that.
There is one guy who definitely believes that Northwestern has a chance to win this ball game. That is our Adrian Carson. He's the former long snapper for the Wildcats, but he's got other business on his mind as we throw it back down to the Georgia Dome and Mr. Carson. Adrian?
Well, Chris, over the last 15 years, it's been a lot of fun covering college football, but especially it's been a blast over the last 15 weeks. You know why? Because a lot of our college football fans logged on while they're watching Ron and Mike and myself during the game and asked Adrian at ESPN.com to do just about anything, to be my producer on the field. The idea was, okay, I will do just about anything. Well, the motivation for this website actually came 10 years ago at Folsom Field in Boulder, Colorado. The whole idea was, ask and you shall receive. Couple hours just before kickoff, the Rebel football team will make their way here into the Grove underneath the Walk of Champions arch just behind me. If all of our college football fans want to log on and ask Adrian to tailgate like this, then I say just keep those computerized cards and letters coming. Memorial Stadium, dedicated in 1924 as a tribute to all the Illinois students who lost their lives during World War I. You know, I think a lot of people walk past these columns to watch a college football game never knowing the significance of them, but now hopefully they do, just because a lot of you logged on.
From our right, Adrian, you're incredible. He's doing the best job of any sideline reporter in the country. He's all over the place.
I couldn't agree more.
Afternoon.
So at 9 G's, it feels like a 270-pound defensive tackle sitting on your head. So naturally, terra firma for me never felt so good. Students haven't been in here since the mid-70s. I know it's a little grim, but I could sleep in here. Yeesh. Football is a blast, Eddie. I'll tell you, ask Adrian to do just about anything, and he will. to Kelly Handelson, Daniel Dodd, and Corey Kelly, all my thanks, and to all the people at ESPN who put up with me for the last 10, 15 years. We will be back to the second half of the Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl. It's just a moment.
Been in business for a long time, and the philosophy has always been customer and people oriented.
I expect them to treat the customer with respect and work on the car the way they would want their car to be worked on.
I like all of my technicians to think that the lady that they're serving is my mother.
I like to have my employees treat a customer as they were next door neighbors.
As the owner of my Jiffy Lube, I expect our customers to be treated as well as I would like to be treated.
When I think of NCAA football, I have memories of magical moments.
I think of the great rivalry. I think of our fantastic fans.
I think of our incredible marching band.
I think of working together as a team. TEAM, together everyone achieves more.
Score at the Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl is Georgia Tech 14-3 over LSU. On the field, the national events band across America halftime show. Nearly 2,000 high school students with a salute to America. Halftime show here at the Georgia Dome. Mike Godfrey, in that first half, defensively, particularly the down lineman for Georgia Tech, had a field day. What does LSU have to do in the second half?
I think there's two things. Great gathers. They've got to find a way to contain him and block him because he's not giving Josh Goody any time to throw the football. You've got to be able to put a tight end over there or use a back. And here he makes a tackle in the backfield. But he comes off a block here and destroys Josh Goody's timing. So they have to control him. That's number one. The second thing is you're always looking for a spark as a coach, and I'm not so sure that you bring in Rohan Davey because he may spark you. You see the big statistic right here, and this is Josh Goody, it's not fair to him. They can't run the ball, which means Georgia Tech's going to pin their ears back and come back after him. So the adjustments, I'm looking forward to the adjustments that they do with Greg Gathers, and I believe you'll see Rohan Davey here in the second half.
Well, the big fella's up and loosening on the sideline, so time will tell. Manje to kick it off, Davis and Devery Henderson, the two deep men for the Tigers. Yards on the return, and Adrian, let's check with you on the sideline.
Ron, the word out of the LSU Bayou Bengal locker room is this. The first half represents a whole lot of the LSU season so far. They believe in Josh Goody, but he's working too hard, and he's not getting enough production out of his offense. Rohan Davey is a possibility if Goody doesn't get it done in the first or second period. Well, here he is right now.
Well, the crowd in the end zone to the south agrees with the move, I can tell you. They got up and gave a standing ovation. They go to the running play.
And it'll be close to 5 yards on the carry by Tofield. Nick Rogers holding on to him.
Well, you're looking for a spark as the head coach and the assistants. When you get in the locker room at halftime, they talked about it. You don't want to blame all this on Josh Booty. But you need a spark. You need somebody to come in and get this team to play right now. So you make the change. Bring Rohan Davey in. We saw what he did against Tennessee on one ankle. He played with a hurt ankle and led the LSU Tigers to win over Tennessee in overtime.
Georgia Tech showing blitz with the safety. They come up tight, play action. Dumps this one off. There's Tommy Banks, 40 to the 45, and the initial first down of the second half will go to the LSU Tigers.
And another adjustment you see, Brandon Winey, the number 68, who was hurt. You talked about it in the first half. He has now come in at tackle. So these are the adjustments they're making. They start Rohan Davey. They bring Brandon Winey in, say, you got to handle Greg Gathers.
We'll show you in just a moment. Winey broke a bone in his thumb. And on the punch of a pass block, it really, really hurts him. Blitz, quick pass. Got the hot route complete to Reed. Almost broke it free. Takes it across midfield and down to the 40. Good for 16 yards. Myers defensively.
A check off at the line of scrimmage. We talked about how Georgia Tech was disguising things that in the first half. All of a sudden, now you get this big cushion out here. And Rohan Davey checks off and gets the ball to Josh Reed against the blitz. Good call by Rohan Davey.
See that pass on Wani's hand? It is the adductor bone right there in that thumb, the one that is broken. He's going to go with a running play. Tofield running very, very hard. I was interested in talking. You said you were well aware of this, but Jack Marucci, the trainer, talked about once they got him bandaged up, and you have to go to the officials, he said it's mandatory in the SEC that they also have to do paperwork and turn it into the league office after that happens to see what everybody is doing and if people are coming up with casts that don't need to be there and use it as a weapon.
Yeah, there'll be a soft cast, and the officials will come in the locker room and test or check out every cast that you have, and they'll okay them.
Commissioner Kramer of the Southeastern Conference on hand watching the Tigers today. They creep up again. Go with a running play in the backfield. A hit Tofield. As soon as he got the ball, Key Fox had already come across the line of scrimmage.
He came from the outside and was not blocked, number 54. Again, they timed this one up. You see him come off the corner. Now he's making a tackle on Tofield before he gets a chance to get anything done.
Well, Georgia Tech causing the same thing that happened in the first half, making LSU have a lousy first down and a not real good second down.
And put him in third and five or more.
Yeah. Davey gets his pass, has it complete. That's a nice throw to Gerald Myers.
And this is the spark that Nick Saban and Jimbo Fisher wanted out of their backup quarterback, Rohan Davey. He's a captain. Adrian talked about he's very, very well liked by this football team. Finally healthy. Played in four games. Started versus Tennessee and Florida. Gutsy performance against Tennessee.
Chris Young got turned around on that. If he just turned around, he could have put a hand up and knocked it down. But a real nice touch by Davey. 3 of 3, 39 yards. Georgia Tech creeping him up. That quick pass again. Pass just incomplete to Reed. Adrian Carson, let's check with you on the sideline.
It was that man, number 25, Josh Reed, who finally said after UAB and then the game and then the Tennessee win that you've got to buy into Josh Booty. Okay, he didn't win the game against Tennessee, but Rohan is hurt. So we've got to get behind someone. Ron, very honestly, there are a lot of guys on this team who wanted Rohan to be the starter. On the other hand, there are a lot of guys who wanted Josh to be the starter. Finally, Booty became the starter, but there comes a point when the coach has more to say than even Josh Reed, who made this. That big catch there.
Adrian, they got a first and goal. The ball just outside the 7-yard line. Two tight ends, I formation, and they go with a run. Tofield inside the 5, up the 4, maybe the 3. Darrell Smith comes up to make the tackle. Georgia Tech, Rogers with 5 tackles in the first half. Key Fox now with 5 in the game, all of them solo. And Myers with 3. All of his are solo.
Again, again, it's not all Josh Booty, because they didn't block anybody in the first half. So I don't mean to, and I don't want anybody to say that Josh Booty's the reason LSU didn't perform in the first half. They didn't perform because their offensive line didn't perform.
Again, two tight end formation. Power eye set. Edwards, the third tight end, he is lined up at a wing. Play action, wide open is Banks, and he throws it. Touchdown, Tommy Banks. And here come the Tigers back. Josh Booty comes out as the holder.
What you want when you insert your second quarterback, you wanted him to be able to pick up the level of play of every player on your football team. And he did that. Rohan, Davey, everybody played a little bit better in the addition of Brandon Whining.
Good pass. Carbello stickers up, and he's no good. He yanked that thing to the left. So a missed extra point. 10:59 left in the third quarter. Quiets the crowd just a little bit, but they're still cheering. And as we take a break, it is Rohan Davey who comes on and is perfect. Throws to Banks for the touchdown. We'll be right back.
Cows and Sports calendar containing $30 worth of food. Visit ChickfilAPeachBowl.com by midnight tonight.
Did you ever see that movie, You've Got Mail? Where this guy and girl fall in love emailing each other a bunch of times? Anyway, they finally meet face to face, and there's this big romantic kiss. You know the movie I'm talking about? Did you ever see that one? Well, this guy didn't. Ford F-Series Super Duty. Built Ford tough.
Davey on the phone upstairs to Jimbo Fisher, the offensive coordinator. You look at Booty on the sideline, and it's tough, but like Mike said, it was not all of Booty in the first half, but I'll tell you, Rohan not only came in with a lot of poise, Mike, he threw a couple of touch passes that were absolutely perfect.
I like the way he's talking to his coach, though. He's showing emotion. I mean, he's bought into this game now. Now the defense and special teams has to raise their level for LSU.
Fans are really making some noise right now. Just kicked 3 yards deep in the end zone. It's going to be returned by Campbell. And Campbell runs into his own man, and then it's going to be tackled at the 15.
And they didn't get back to their average start at 20.5 yards. So the red line, they did not make it back to the red line.
LSU with a special teams player shaken up and is hobbling off the field at the 8-yard line.
Now George Godsey's got to answer this. A touchdown by Rohan Davey.
So let's see if Georgia Tech can put together a perfect second half as far as no turnovers. 4 yards
rushing, so they opened up LSU's defense to the run game.
They're going to run again. They pull the guard, hit behind the line of scrimmage. Falk is right there to stuff that one. And right now, Ole Miss is wearing purple and gold.
Well, how many times do you see it? A guy that's well-liked on your football team comes off the bench and leads your team, and all of a sudden, everybody jumps on his bandwagon.
Falk now the leader in the ballgame in tackles with 8, 4 solo, and he also has a fumble recovery. Second down, 12. Gadsby keeps it on the ground. Burns will take it across the 15, stopped at the 16, and I mean the LSU cheering section who are right. They are roaring with every step that the Tigers take. And so far, every step they've taken in the second half has been the correct one.
Now, defensively, they're running better. They're running to the ball better.
Third down. Line to make. He's out at the 26. 3 of 6 tonight in third down conversions for the Jackets. Gatsby, under pressure, throws the ball too high. Nate Curry, the intended receiver.
That's what you want out of that drive, LSU's defense. Now special teams has a chance to take over.
Looks like Jeremy Lawrence, the strong side linebacker, was shaken up on the play. They're helping him off. Trev Falk stuck around to help his teammate.
Dominic Davis is a long ball threat here, catching this punt.
Van Dyke stands to punt. His third to kick. The net punt average, 43.6, so we'll chart it for you.
Check that red line out, see if Dominic Davis can get by it.
Driving spiral. Davis all the way back to the 26-yard line. Breaks by two tacklers, and he should have taken out over the 37, maybe the 38. Kerry Watkins makes the tackle. 46 on the kick, 11 on the return, a net of 35. So we'll take a break. 9:15 left in the third. Tigers making a roar.
Through Monday, Zales is having an after-Christmas clearance sale where you can get up to 60% off and more on a great selection of jewelry so you can get what you really want. Now through Monday at Zales stores nationwide or shop online at Zales.com.
You know the Fight Club, right? Where this group of guys get together in some warehouse or basement or whatever. And they just get beaten up. Go to work the next day, raped and scarred and wearing bruises like badges of honor. Now there's a hobby that separates the men from the boys. The new Ford Ranger Edge. Built Ford tough.
A battle of big play quarterbacks as Oregon's Joey Harrington faces the Longhorn duo of Sims and Applewhite. Texas versus Oregon, December 29th at 8:30 on ESPN.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of the 2000 Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl is brought to you by Ford F-Series. The best-selling trucks are built Ford tough. And by Morgan Stanley, Dean Witter. Move your money, get well connected. And by Beck's, a beer apart. Rohan Davey, 5 of 5, 57 yards and a touchdown on the first drive, and he comes back out with the offense again.
Ron, in the game we had at Tennessee, Josh Reed, a converted tailback, number 25, was a big receiver for Rohan Davey.
Reed, 2 catches for 31, zings this one complete to the man we were just talking about, and the tackle is made by Clark.
Yet when you have a favorite receiver, you like to go to him, and he has confidence in Josh Reed. Josh Reed's 5'11", 200 pounds, 65 catches this year, second in school history with 10 touchdown receptions. And I like what they're doing on first down. They're throwing on first down. They've got a good mix here so far in the second half.
Second and four. Pitch goes back to Davis. Turns the corner. Has the first down across midfield. Put a head down and ran over Jeremy Myers, much to the delight of his teammates right there on the sideline. Michael Lilly with an outstanding block.
Here's what you like to see if you're a coach. You like seeing your bench being into the football game. This bench of LSU is excited. I mean, they're all in this football game. The fans are in this football game. These guys aren't lollygagging around. They're watching intently, and they're pulling for their teammates.
That's a gain of 8 yards. That's the longest run from scrimmage since back in the first quarter for the Tigers. Safeties creep up. Pressure hit. Ball is loose and picked up by Davis. And now it's being whistled down as an incomplete pass.
Greg gathers again. You know, every time he makes a hit on the LSU quarterback, he's making a statement. How do you like me now? Am I too small? He is playing with a motor in this football game. Number 55. Brandon Winey tries to cut him. See, that's a short pass game. That's Rohan Davey's fault. That's a short pass. He needs to get it off. He's trying to pump him to go, but he doesn't have time enough to do that.
Gathers four tackles, three hurries. So it's a second down and 10. Here comes the blitz off the corner. They go straight ahead with Davis, and he will go inside the 45 to the 44. Wimbush, the inside linebacker on the tackle.
When you can't control a guy like Greg Gathers, then you have to figure a way in play calling with screens, delays, draws, quick things that will frustrate him a little bit and let you chop Greg Gathers a little bit. So look for LSU maybe to screen him a little bit here in the second half.
Gathers has been moved into tackle on this play rather than at that defensive end spot. Shotgun formation on third and six. Got a man open for a too high to read. Ooh, buddy. And he had him.
He had the first down.
He really had the first down, plus about 8 or 9 more yards. First bad pass that he's really thrown as far as being off the mark.
Still should have been caught, though, but it was high.
Rhino, the deep man, 8 punts for LSU tonight. Donnie Jones, been a very, very busy guy. High, spiral will not turn over. Caught by Rhino, no fair catch, and he's going to get a couple of yards on the return as Damian James is there on the special teams to make the tackle. 28 on the punt, 3 on the return.
Georgia Tech needs to go back to Burns. Joe Burns, the tailback, a little bit. Hatch came on late in the first quarter, second quarter, but their running game was very effective in the first half with Burns.
Burns, the lone setback. Godsey to throw. Up the far sideline. Got a man, and it's intercepted. Right there is Clark.
Well, Georgia Tech just keeps leading LSU back into this football game. Bad decision here by George Godsey. Trying to get the ball to Kelly Campbell. He hung it up, and Ryan Clark, the free safety to Phil Almation, the defensive coordinator, loves. He just breaks on the football, goes high for the interception, picks it off.
Came a long way, Mike.
He really did. He's got great range. You need a center fielder. The one thing LSU talked about, they're strong in the middle. You know, the baseball, if you have a good catcher, pitcher, and center fielder, well, they got a good middle guard, good linebackers, and a good free safety in Ryan Clark.
5 turnovers for the Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets. Counter play. Tokyo. breaks off the tackle, breaks off another, has 5, 6, 7, and it may be a 9-yard gain in the play because of the second effort.
Georgia Tech is the team walking around now. LSU is putting it to them. This is where you just think about George Gotti. He's had Ralph Regan for the last couple of seasons to talk to. They're one coach short today, Georgia Tech, because of Ralph Regan leaving for Maryland.
Second down and very short for the Tigers. And they go with the running play, make sure they pick up the first down, and they do. And let's check on the sideline. Speaking of Ralph, who's with Adrian?
Ron Warner, probably one of the most talked about coaches in college football right now, told me last night with all his heart he would love to coach this game. Ralph, bittersweet moment for you.
Yes, it is. Right now I'm just pulling for Georgia Tech and hope we hang in there and win this thing.
That last interception, Coach, you're rather emotional.
Well, we haven't done that all year, and that's the thing you can't do is beat ourselves. We've been a very efficient team, and, you know, that's the difference in this game right now, that we've turned it over. We've moved the ball, and I think Billy's done a great job of mixing formations and keeping people off balance, but you can't stop yourself when you turn the ball over.
Bill O'Brien has done a phenomenal job, Coach, but I need to ask you honestly, were you on that sideline right now? What adjustment would you make?
Tell them to stop turning the ball over. You know, I don't know how much you can do to control that. I mean, you got to take care of the football. It's a very precious thing. And you know, the thing that LSU is doing right now is they're pressing them up and playing man to man. And George just went for a one-on-one situation. He just hung it up a little bit too much, and the free safety made a great play.
Ron, less and less these days in college football do you see a man go back to his alma mater to coach. A Maryland man has gone home to coach the Terrapins. Coach, thank you very much for taking time. Ron, we're all on the edges of our seat up here.
Turnover and the fumble recovered by Key Fox. And Tofield is arguing that he was down, that the fumble came after the play. Look at Key Fox on the sideline. Was he down? Yes. So Georgia Tech gets it back, and you hear the boo. The crowd just saw it here on the screens, and the officials didn't get to look at the replay, but they heard that reaction. Blitz right up the middle, maybe 1 yard of the running play. Dawson comes through to hit Burns. Look at this fumble by Tofield. Looks like he was hitting the turf. Yep.
Yeah, his knee was down.
That's yesterday's news, though. You got to move on.
Georgia Tech, two tight ends. This time they go to the short side of the field. Tripped up at the line of scrimmage. Maybe a gain of a couple on the play as Davis makes the tackle, and there's a flag down. Georgia Tech.
Georgia Tech just out of sync right now on offense.
But obviously the best thing that happened to them is the recovered fumble that Key Fox got just a moment ago. But beyond that, Mike, they haven't had a lot of good things happen to them in the third quarter.
No, and Bill O'Brien just searching for something now. He had everything in the first half at his disposal. Now he's just searching for something to find to go to. LSU blitzing a lot here in the second half.
Gotcha. Gets it away, and the ball's drop hit him right in the hands. Nate Curry.
I think the receivers have had a hard time on this turf also today. They seems like just haven't made plays. This ball is out. You just can't get both hands extended. Not on that play, but several plays they're trying to come back to the ball and seem like they get their feet stuck in the turf.
Five drops against the Yellow Jackets. If you look at the numbers,
the big one is two interceptions.
From the shotgun, good protection this time. Jumps it right over the middle. This is Burns, 25 out to the 28. It'll be enough for the Georgia Tech first down. And now here come late flags in. Beg your pardon, that's the front end of the stick because they had third down and a distance, 21 yards to get the first. But now let's see what the late markers that came in are about.
The NCAA run assigns different crews to the bowl game so that you get a neutral crew. This is from Conference USA.
Lytle Thomas, the strong safety, is
dead
injured.
Ball, personal foul on the offense after the play, half the distance to the goal, he fourth down.
Looked like Brent Key around after the whistle. There's the block.
And that's a post-play foul, so the play is over. It now is fourth down, and the penalty goes half the distance to the goal line. Capital One Bowl Week continues tomorrow on ESPN with the Sylvania Alamo Bowl at 8 o'clock Eastern. Quarterback Eric Crops leads number 8 Nebraska against running back Damian Anderson and the number 19 Northwestern Wildcats. For more, log on to ESPN.com, your home for college football on the Internet. Think Adrian will watch that?
I think a lot of people will watch that. That'll be a highly rated game.
I think it'll be a fun football game.
Northwestern has had a great year. Randy Walker and the staff, they get time to get people healthy, and I think they'll play with Nebraska.
I do, too. A lot of different names mentioned for Coach of the Year, but Walker certainly had to be given a lot of consideration, as well as three or four other coaches. Here's the boot. Line drive. This is a beauty. Davis from the 42-yard line of LSU. And he's going to have about 5 yards on the return as Kerry Watkins is downfield to make the tackle. So it's 44 on the punt and 5 on the return. We'll take a timeout. 3:43 remaining. Georgia Tech 14-9.
AT&T Broadband keeps you connected with programming, offers, and more. Look what we're bringing you this month. Tis the season to join Fox family for 25 days of holiday movies and Christmas specials you grew up with. The 25 days of Christmas, only on Fox Family.
Weeknights on E. It's the story you haven't heard. The E! True Hollywood Story. Weeknights at 9 Eastern and Pacific. Only on E!
AT&T Broadband. We're keeping you connected.
What about this one? All right.
Can't find the right car for you? Shop VHICS.com. Want access to a half million used cars? VHICS.com. Lease or purchase? VHICS.com. Or do side-by-side comparisons? VHICS.com. Need to find the right local dealer? VHICS.com. Find the right car for you. VHICS.com. Roadmap to the automotive world.
There's only one place to go for the most complete NFL pregame coverage anywhere. Join Chris.
Oh, my God, it might make it.
He is being forced to live by a separate set of rules.
More.
Teams seem to get beat up there on that AstroTurf.
Sterling.
If they don't run the ball with commitment today, then this is who you are.
And Stewart is about as black and blue as Borussia Park's tight.
Everything you need to know right up until kickoff from the guys who know it best. ESPN Sunday NFL Countdown. Sundays 11 Eastern on ESPN.
The score 14-9, Georgia Tech. And a reminder, tonight's Morgan Stanley, Dean Witter, well-connected storyline for LSU. Booty in the first half, 8 of 19, 110 yards. Then Davey in the second half, 7 of 9, 63 yards and a touchdown. Turnovers, LSU with a crucial one on the last drive, 5 against Tech. And rushing yardage, now LSU with 48.
And Ron, George O'Leary during that timeout was lighting up his offense. He was getting into their face, and he knows he's lost a veteran coach in Ralph Friedgen, and he's trying to pick up that role. Now, he bristled a little bit this week when people asked him about the loss of Ralph Friedgen, because you're a staff, so you figure one guy's not going to make that big of an effect. So he's trying to get his attention of his team.
Davey, play action, and as they roll the pocket, he's got a man open deep, his tight end, and didn't have time to get it off to him. Davey, gonna scramble to the 45-yard line. Domingo over the middle, who is not the fastest of the tight ends, had gotten himself free.
This is the first time since the Tennessee game that Rohan Davey has been healthy. He's thrown 8 touchdown passes, only 1 interception. You see the tight end out there? But he didn't have time. He made the right decision to pick up as many yards as he can, scrambling with the football.
Key Fox made the tackle. Boy, you could see the explosion. That young man is so quick. Fox is going to be a great football player. Right up the middle, big opening. Flag is down. Cofield will have the first down plus a lot of yardage. Fox again on the stop.
Looks like movement on LSU.
Thursday, January the 11th on ESPN, it's the 2001 ESPY Award nomination special at 10 Eastern. Among the 34 awards to be given out at this year's ceremony, we'll announce the nominees for Male and Female Athletes of the Year, College and Pro Teams of the Year, Comeback and Breakthrough Athletes of the Year, as the best in sports get ready to descend on Las Vegas for the ESPYs in February.
I want to go to the ESPYs one of these years. I know you're busy with basketball.
It's always on Monday, and we have a big Monday game every year.
I'm waiting for an in.
Blitz is on. Ball is hit and knocked down to Kalina Scrimmage. Who else? Key Fox. Good heavens, this young man is making a statement as far as next year.
Making some busts at the line of scrimmage, and that's what I keep watching. Rodney Reed, he's talking to LeBrandon Tofield. I think Reed went outside. Tofield had to go inside. They both went outside the block, and Key Fox comes inside. Watch this. Now, see, look, it's a complete bust at the line of scrimmage. What you have to do at the line of scrimmage collectively as a unit is guys knows what they're doing on defense.
Third down. They need to take it to the Georgia Tech 43-yard line. 2:39 remaining, third quarter. Right up in the middle, got it complete for the first down at the 34 to Josh Reed. Reed did not have a catch in the first half. He has 5 in the third quarter.
There's a chemistry between Reed and Davey, and they got a feel for each other. And Rohan Davey drills this football into Josh Reed.
Well, you're right. Kids, all of a sudden, they have a good sense about each other as far as timing, the way they break off their routes and what have you.
They know it. They know they have a feel for each other.
Huge first down for LSU.
Still waiting for that tight end play, Robert Royal.
Blitz from the free safety. They throw it to Reed again. And Myers is the man who will make the tackle.
Again, Rohan Davey is recognizing defensive coverages, and he knows he's got a 5-6 yard gain out there when they blitz the safety to Josh Reed. It's a game of adjustments. You make an adjustment, I have to make an adjustment. And right now, LSU is doing things right on offense.
Davey, 9 of 11, 90 yards and a touchdown. They'll run him with Tokyo. Inside the 25, around the 24. Key Fox makes still another tackle.
Been a different offensive line since Brandon Winey's come into this football game.
Third down and inches, LSU. You gonna run it on fourth anyway? Do you play action to put it up here?
No, I think I go right behind Brandon Winey.
Tommy Bank, all 275 pounds, would have the first down, plus about 3 yards.
Hey, Brandon Wynie has given you the same thing as Rohan Davey has given you at the offensive line. He's kind of got them playing at a little different level in the second half. So just lead with him and follow him with Tommy Banks, and they pick up the first down.
Wynie, a senior out of Lake Charles, 6'7", 288 pounds, didn't play in the first half because of that broken bone, and we showed you the cast on the opening series of the second half. Here comes the blitz again. Play action. Davey just throws it into the ground. Very smart play. Didn't even want Banks to catch it because everybody was covered. Credit the Georgia Tech secondary. They had them blanketed.
Sure, Nick Saban went to Wynie at halftime and said, how's your hand? And he may have said, it still hurts, but it's healed because you're going into that football game. We need you. This Greg Gathers is killing us.
Mike, again, the pressure on that play coming from Fox. You have to think, even as a sophomore, he may be first-team all-conference preseason selection for next year.
He's got a knack for the football.
He really does. He's got all the tools. Eighth play of the drive. Georgia Tech creeping up. They stay at home. Reed. Mike, talk about what you do and do it well executed with the quick pass game. The offensive line that time, super job of just chop and get them down.
And that's the answer. Jimbo Fisher with a nice job here in the second half. Josh Reed's the inside receiver. You see the offensive line chopping at the line of scrimmage. Quick pass outside to Josh Reed. You pick up the first down against Chris Young.
First down, Tigers. First down and goal. They trail 14-9. We have 18 seconds showing on the clock in the third quarter.
Here's where you like a back like Tokyo, 227 pounds.
Two tight end alignment. That's Banks in motion. They give it to Tokyo, right side. Puts the head down, but he got banged hard by Corrin. Brian Corrin, the big senior out of Albany, Georgia. Runs at four, now at three, and we're about to head to the final 15 minutes of this one. It was a quarter that the LSU faithful to our right really, really enjoyed. As we head to the fourth and final 15 minutes, our score is Georgia Tech 14, LSU 9, and the Tigers are threatening.
ESPN's 2001 Almanac, a great holiday gift in bookstores now.
I told my father I wanted to grow up to be a teacher. Wouldn't you rather be a doctor? He said. It's a noble profession and you could become wealthy. That may be true, I said. But without teachers, where would doctors come from?
Bunch of individuals. They always had some cockamamie scheme to get out of a jam. It never sounded like it would work, but of course it always did. Week after week, same time, same chapter. Those were my boys. The Ford F-150 Supercruise, built for you.
Seattle is surrounded by water, and then it rains. That means car accidents. When that happens, are you going to have a State Farm agent who knows you personally, or are you going to have no agent and hope for the best?
Over 16,000 State Farm agents.
Our rates are very competitive.
It's no accident. They insure more cars than anyone else.
I'm going to be getting some calls today.
Yes.
One more time. But it's something I'm serious.
Sure, let's play for a buck.
I'm not that serious.
Guy, a dollar isn't serious.
Then you must not know about 10-10-220.
Remind me. Stop 10-10-220. All calls up to 20 minutes, 99 cents.
Just 7 cents a minute after that.
Got to be a monthly fee.
No.
In that case, I'll shoot for a buck.
Can you do that?
Too short. Dial 10-10-220.
Thank you.
2000 sports calendar containing $30 worth of food. Visit ChickfilAPeachBowl.com by midnight tonight.
Welcome back. Hold that, Tigers. Just struck up by the LSU band. And the purple and gold just went nuts. Part of the 73,614, a new record for the Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl just announced here at the stadium. On the field, second down and goal from the 9.
Ron, here's where a good tight end, Robert Rowe, has not caught the ball today, but here's a good position to try to get him the football.
Let's watch for him. As Rohan Davey sets in the pocket, lobs it for the end zone, he just throws this one away. Double coverage on Reed that time as Clay Brooks was applying pressure.
Yeah, they're going to make sure Josh Reed didn't catch the football. The combination you like down here is the tight end Robert Royal and the fullback Tommy Banks.
157 yards in the third quarter for LSU to only 13. The Georgia Tech. Mike just mentioned it is a game of adjustment, and obviously the LSU staff has done an awfully good job of adjustments in this second half.
Robert Royal right inside here to tight end.
Pressure. Rohan Marley. Did he get a foot down? Touchdown. Josh Reed. Rohan Davey with the touchdown pass. And I mean Reed got one foot
down. Rohan Davey gets time. He gets this ball, lost it up. Number 25, Josh Reed, comes down, gets his feet down.
Yep, right there.
Left foot down before the right foot came in the white. That was close.
Going for two, trying to make it a 17-14 ball game. And they have elected to have the ball placed at the left hash mark.
See if they motion Tommy Banks to the right side here. Nope, they're going to try to balance him up with Tofield.
Tofield in motion, blitz is on. Hit, gets the pass away, and it is caught. Josh Reed has had an all-world second hit. Nick Rogers was all over. But the difference, Rohan Davey was 240 pounds. He's hard to knock off his feet.
That's before Christmas. I think he weighs more now. But he couldn't take him down. Rohan Davey, strength enough to throw the football. Reed with another great play.
So let's take a timeout. What a reversal as far as momentum and fortune in a quarter and just a minute. New score, LSU 17-14.
We never know when a storm is going to hit.
Call me later.
I will. There are thousands of us at Georgia Power ready to go at the drop of a hard hat. We have one of the most sophisticated systems in the country. Hopefully, our customers will barely feel a thing. Of course, sometimes Mother Nature knocks off early. That's okay, too. We know she's coming back. We'll be ready.
Still in the news, the Buick year-end sell-off continues unabated. When Buick issued an additional $500 holiday bonus on select 2001 models, bringing total cashback offers up to $1,500, analysts predicted an immediate spike in market activity. Now, eager buyers are still storming the floor with no sign of a slowdown. You have to wonder, though, with holiday bonus cash ending January 2nd, how long can these market conditions last?
I want to tell you about a brand new way.
Brand new way of quitting smoking.
It's unique. It's effective. It's orange.
New Nicorette Orange.
Nicorette.
So I still help prevent cravings on my own regular schedule.
I still help answer cravings with another piece.
And now I have orange.
Brand new orange flavor. Only from Nicorette.
Here, taste this. Now this just may be a flavor I can quit with.
Sometimes victory's so close.
You can taste it.
You can do it. New Nicorette Orange can help.
think you're on the right track. You save $10 on a $10,000 stock trade, but then you lose $100 because of lousy execution. There are no shortcuts to financial success. Anyone can offer cheap trades. Very few online brokers can offer the world's best financial thinking. Morgan Stanley, Dean Witt. Move your money. Get well connected.
17-14, LSU forges on top as you look at Rohan Davey, the junior out of Miami. And it's not that I'm that big a reggae fan, but I told you before the game, I hope I didn't call him Rohan Marley, and I did. I apologize. Obviously, I know it is Rohan Davey. At the goal line, Campbell. Just shy of the 20-yard line. Now, Mike, take us through a sequence here. If you're offensive coordinator, if you're Georgia Tech, what do you got to do to settle everybody down and do what was so good for them in the first half?
Well, first of all, the catch, Ron. Josh Reed had time enough to get his feet down, and then Rohan Davey with a great play. I think you rely on George Godsey. They scored 14 points in the fourth quarter against Central Florida and came back. They scored 15 points in the fourth quarter to beat Clemson. So they're very capable. They've been in this spot a couple times.
Play action, pressure's on, and Godsey is going to be sacked. 59, Jarvis Green, the second sack of the ball game.
Jarvis Green now has 18 career sacks for LSU. Makes a good play on this bootleg. Never takes the fake inside with the running game and makes the tackle. Now you talk about Georgia Tech. They've got to find a way to get Kelly Campbell involved here.
Lawson.
Just as Josh Reed has done for LSU, Kelly Campbell can do the same thing for Georgia Tech.
Second and 17. Sets in the pocket. Gets this one complete. Tackle made, but the 20 ball came loose. LSU football. Recovered by James. Now here comes a flag in and a second flag across the way. It's going to be celebration or what?
LSU, yeah.
Come down after the interception, LSU 15-yard penalty, first down.
Here's the biggest problem you have if you're George Godsey. See, nobody's talking to him. Ralph Friedgen is the quarterback coach. Ralph Friedgen would be right here right now talking to him. Here's the play. Nate Curry gets the football, gets stripped by Demetrius Hookbin. But now you go off to the sideline and you're one coach short to settle your quarterback down, George Godsey.
So the penalty assessed as you look at Ralph Friedgen.
And he'd like to be on that field to settle his quarterback down.
First down, safety coming up on the blitz, pumped it once, going to go deep over the middle, and just a little too far for Reggie Robinson. Adrian Karsten, what do you have for us?
I have the fourth quarter. This is when fatigue sets in. The defensive line for Georgia Tech was off the field for one play. Ron, they dragged their butts back onto the field. The offensive line barely got their butts onto the field in the last series. 6 degrees difference. When I was sitting with Ralph Regan halfway up the stadium, it was 6 degrees cooler. Usually heat rises, but this is a dome. The heat has no place to go except settle in. Georgia Tech is really dragging right now.
Okay, Adrian.
Short drop this time to Hopper out. Threw it just a little too high for Josh Reed.
Reed, by the way, 8 catches for 85 yards.
Adrian giving us an anatomy lesson there.
Mr. Wizard.
Yeah.
No, not an anatomy.
Remember, Georgia Tech has owned the possession time all season. LSU is in control of this football game. They need a play here. You talk about Georgia Tech. They got to reach back right now and settle, make LSU settle for a field goal attempt.
Third down. The line to make is the Georgia Tech 22-yard line. You can see the numbers. The Tigers are 5 of 14 on third down conversion. Right over the middle, Myers can't hold on. Hester with a defensive play, and that is a good defensive stand by Georgia Tech at a time they had to have it.
Yeah, three-man rush, Ron, right here. They got eight covering, so Rohan Davey can't find an opening.
Okay, so this means when we look at the field goal attempt by Corbello, they got to place it down at the 39-yard line. So 49 yards, his longest is against Tennessee, which is 47 yards.
Indoors, you got a shot.
Booty to Holder. Plenty of distance on the kick, and he is good. New career long for Corbello. That ties a school record. Let's take a break. 20-14 LSU.
Purchases would be interest-free until July 2001.
We gotta tell Bob and Carol about Capital One.
What did you want to
do? Still in the news, the Buick year-end sell-off continues unabated. When Buick issued an additional $500 holiday bonus on select 2001 models, bringing total cashback offers up to $1,500, analysts predicted an immediate spike in market activity. Now, eager buyers are still storming the floor with no sign of a slowdown. You have to wonder, though, with holiday bonus cash ending January 2nd, how long can these market conditions last?
Playmaker Eric Crouch in the impenetrable Cornhusker front spar with Northwestern's Damian Anderson. Nebraska versus Northwestern at 8. Saturday on ESPN.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of the 2000 Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl is presented by Chick-fil-A. We didn't invent the chicken, just the chicken sandwich. And in part by Buick and your local Buick dealers. Welcome back to the Georgia Dome. Ron Franklin, Mike Gottfried, Adrian Karsten. Part of a triple header today. Great game up in Memphis at the Liberty Bowl, won by Colorado State. This one right here. Georgia Tech having their way in the first half, and now here come the Tigers back in the second half. And in the wings, on deck, the Holiday Bowl, the Culligan Holiday Bowl out in San Diego, Oregon, and Texas. Fun day of college football.
Georgia Tech's average starting at the 19.7 yards, and they go out of the end zone, you gain a half.
Corbello will kick this one at 6 yards deep and away from the return man. So they'll get it at the 20.
Remember the missed extra point, because that looms big here. 20-14. You're a touchdown and an extra point away from taking that lead. And Ron, I really believe Georgia Tech has got to find Kelly Campbell and get him involved here.
You see the numbers on Godsey, 11 of 23, 84 yards, two interceptions, as Georgia Tech has turned it over six times in this ballgame. Godsey, short drop. There's the quick look in, and he catches the slant, tackled immediately by Damian James, Kerry Watkins, the receiver.
When you look at Kelly Campbell, he's caught 12 touchdown passes, 59 receptions. He averages 87.5 yards per game. You know what he has today? Two catches, 9 yards. He's more more of a threat. You got to find a way to get the football in.
And those two catches came in the first half.
Mm-hmm. It has been flanked in the second half.
Second down and short. It's Myers in motion. Keep it on the ground, and they're going to have the first down. Joe Burns will take it straight ahead. Huge cheer from the Georgia Tech faithful here because they'd like to see them do just that. Just run the football, maintain control a little bit here, and gain the momentum back. Josh Reed on the sideline getting a well-deserved rest. No catches in the first half. 8 catches in the second half. 85 yards and a touchdown. Little counterplay. This time, a little greeting committee there for Burns, and he will have a yard, maybe a yard and a half.
Kareem Mitchell, number 97, is filling in for Muskingum Barnes, playing well here in the second half. 97, 6'4", 251.
Here comes that linebacker on the blitz. There's a safety. Dotsie hit as he gets it away and just throws it well over the head of the receiver. That was Lionel Thomas from the strong safety spot, a junior out of Opelousas.
See, when you choose your time to blitz, Phil Almation, the defensive coordinator for LSU, now is making a good use of his safeties. There's a safety blitz. Never gave a chance for George Godsey.
Third down. Georgia Tech has to take it to the 42-yard line to keep this drive going, or they got to kick it away again.
See, here's another problem. You get in a bad formation.
3 of 8 on third down conversions. Blitz for the linebacker. Pass is caught, and he's close to the first down. Kelly Campbell, the man that Mike was just talking about, and I believe he's going to move the chains.
I'd keep throwing to him, and eventually you're going to get a long ball to him. Bill O'Brien doing a nice job mixing his plays up. Kelly Campbell, this ball was thrown on time.
LSU had better get lined up here, Mike. They're still making changes in Georgia Tech at the line of scrimmage.
They don't have
a timeout being called. They don't have enough men on the field, do they?
No, they got 9. That's tough to play with 9. I know they got a motion, but it's tough to play with 9.
11:37 left in the ballgame. LSU 20, Georgia Tech 14.
Give your walls a new look for the new year with Dutch Boy Paint from Menards. Dirt Fighter Flat is on sale just $10.99 a gallon. Semi-gloss, $14.99 a gallon. Get a lifetime of beauty with Moen bath faucets, all on sale. This sleek-looking model is just $59. This model with polished brass accents is $89. Plus, take 10% off everything, even sale prices, when you use your Menards big card.
Save big money at Menards.
We are Unico Designs Limited, the best kept secret of the western suburbs, the store with special clothes for special people. We dress you exquisitely from head to toe. Unico Designs Limited, 4427 Harrison Street, Hillside. Because there's only one you, there's only one Unico.
We've got the SportsCenter DVD coming out, classic shows behind the scenes. Matter of fact, some of the guys are recording anchor commentaries right now.
They give me the most important stories and, you know, try to get me on camera as often as possible. A lot of women find me extremely sexy. Putt's in. See? I putt's in. I already knew it was in. I'm tight with about 300 players. I didn't like my hair this day. I got rid of that hairdresser.
It's a great way for the fans to really get inside our head.
If it's good for ratings and they tell me it is, fine, stick me on camera a lot, and they do quite often.
Well, his confidence, his command seemingly growing by the day. Chris Sims ripped up the Aggies. He's got a lot of weapons for Oregon, but it'll be a challenge against the Ducks' aggressive defense. The Holiday Bowl coming up next, guys.
All righty, that's the third game of our triple header that we were just talking about. Our situation, 11:37 left in the ballgame. LSU by 6. The second half has belonged to them, but an opportunity for the Yellow Jackets here to regain that momentum and also the lead. Here comes the blitz. They go with the run. They bounce it to the outside, and look at Burns puts a head down, and he is going to have a couple of extra yards as Booker will come over to make the tackle, but that is a good, tough run.
Georgia Tech, Bill O'Brien coming with two tight ends now to run the football. When you go two tight ends, you balance up the defense, and you get a helmet on a helmet with two tight ends. And then Joe Burns breaks it outside and just ran over Fred Booker, injured Fred Booker.
Second down and short, play action. Here comes the pressure from the outside. Got his pass away and running for his life. He just threw it away. That was Fred Booker, who was applying pressure on the quarterback.
Well, Nick Saban's a former secondary coach. He coached in pro football. And anytime you're in the hash mark, closest to the boundary, LSU can show you a two-deep coverage and line Fred Booker up in the wide receiver and then bring him because you're real close to the sideline.
Third.
George Godsey was not prepared for that.
Third down. They've got to take it to the 47. Eighth play of the drive for Georgia Tech. Good protection this time. Now it breaks down, and he's going to be sacked. Boy, of all the things you didn't want to happen, that was it right there. Third time that they've gotten to Godsey, and Lawrence and Brady James will share that sack.
Nothing there for George Godsey. You got to throw the football away, but again, good effort by LSU's defense.
Dyke with his fifth punt of the afternoon, a driving spiral. Caught, fair catch is made by Davis inside the 10-yard line. 54 yards in the punt. Well, it's time for you, the viewer, to go online and help us select tonight's player of the game. And here's the list of nominees. For LSU, Davey, Reed, and Whitey. For Georgia Tech, Godsey, Joe Burns, and Greg Gathers. Log on to ESPN.com now and cast your vote. We'll announce the winner late in the fourth quarter.
Ron, that might be the first time we have an offensive tackle on there, Brandon Whiney. But he means so much to this offensive line. He's been able to control Greg Gathers in the second half.
Quick pass. Got it complete to Myers. And that'll be enough for the first down as LSU chips away a gain of 11 right there. Adrian, let's go down to you.
Because Brandon Whiney's pass run is the same color of Georgia Tech's jersey, they have been complaining about the fact he gets to hold. Now, Brent, he's got a broken bone in his left thumb, but he still has movement in those four other fingers. He's grabbing on to the shoulder pads, the blades that come down across the chest of Georgia Tech, and he's getting away with it. Georgia Tech complained about it pregame. They wanted to see the cast. He's been doing a beautiful job blocking.
Well, Adrian, it's a four-fingered hold. First down. They move the chains out beyond the 21-yard line. And Davey will give it to Tofield. Nick Rogers steps up to make the tackle after a short game.
I'm not trying to influence the voters because Brandon Whiney. No, because if I had a vote, obviously, I would vote for number six right now. Now, he would get my second vote right here, Brandon Whiney, because he's done a good job. There, he let go of his defensive lineman, Nick Rogers. But I would vote for Rohan Davey because he has given a spark to everybody in here.
Offense and defense,
yeah,
for that
offense,
matter.
Defense, and the fans from LSU.
LSU leads it by six. Clock running, about to go under 9 minutes left in the ballgame. Pressure is on, gets it away, and that's complete to Banks, the fullback. Breaks the tackle, has another 15 yards, and now an extra 18 after the second effort in breaking the tackle.
Put him back on the list, too, Tommy Banks.
You can't vote for everybody, Mike.
Tommy Banks has had a big football game. But this, in the first half, LSU didn't get this football off, and Rohan Davey gets it off to Tommy Banks, and he's a runaway Buffalo.
That was Gathers, who was putting pressure on the quarterback. And as you said, we mentioned, I mean, Davey is huge. He's 240 pounds. And like you said, that was before Christmas. He's hard to knock off his feet.
He ate a lot of turkey in Christmas.
Banks now, five catches, 65 yards. That's a career high for Tommy Banks. Pitch comes back to the tailback. Tofield puts a head down. And they'll take it across midfield and a gain of about four. Wimbush and Smith on the defensive end.
You talked about Rohan Davey. How much did you say he weighed? 239?
That's what it said when the year started.
Yeah, that's Thanksgiving and Christmas. He's up to 251 now.
251. You know that.
Yeah, he's 251. And a lot of that 251 is underneath that six. Just below the six.
Well, that's just rib pads, Mike.
Yeah. But that's why it's so tough for him to tackle.
Well, for instance, Gathers hit him a good lick just now, but Gathers only weighs 10 more pounds than he does. On second down. Pass over the middle. In and out of the hands of Reed, and he knows, boy, did he have an opportunity. A flag is down back at the line of scrimmage.
Well, that's a beautiful throw. I mean, that's thrown just like you want it thrown on Sundays in the pro league. I mean, that ball was right on the money.
Gathers wanted to make sure he told his coaches.
Knocked the head off.
That's an illegal shift, and he knocks the head of the referee off.
He's telling him, hey, watch my hat.
Randy Finn.
It's a white hat, too.
Take a look at it again.
Oh, he's not worried about his hat, it's his forehead. He got elbows.
Yeah, Greg, just want to make sure that his
defensive coordinator, Ted Roof, knew exactly what the situation was. It's now going to be second down and 11.
You think they go again to Josh Reed?
They're going to go with a running field. Tofield crosses midfield down to around the 46. Darryl Smith there to make the tackle.
Better job of play calling in the second half with draws and screens. Tommy Banks catching the ball in the backfield. And that'll slow the rush down.
And see, that clock right now, seven and a half minutes. For all those incomplete passes, you look at Jimbo Fisher.
Credit Jimbo Fisher with a nice adjustment here in the second half.
Third down. And the Tigers need to go to the 42-yard line of Tech to keep this one going. Otherwise, they got to punt it. Here comes the blitz. All out. Davies' pass is caught. That's Robinson. And trying to get away, he'll have the first down at the 36-and-a-half-yard line.
The other thing that impresses me about Rohan Davey is he's cool. He's a cool customer. Look at him. I mean, he is in this football game. They bring the blitz. They're at his feet. He gets the ball out to Reggie Robinson. Picks up the first down.
Key Fox was the man who hit the quarterback. It was Chris Young who was holding on for dear life. If Chris lets go of him, Reggie Robinson is down the field 37 more yards for a touch.
Now you're Nick Saban. You're thinking about that clock. You also want to be able to tack at least three on here.
Davey, 14 of 22, 157 yards and two touchdowns. Tofield, not much there, and he will go down at the line of scrimmage. Darryl Smith makes the stop. Fumble came after he was down. Clock continues to roll as LSU keeps mixing the plays, but particularly even on the short plays, and this one right here is going to lose about a half yard. But we're about, for the time they snap this ball, we'll be under 5 minutes to play, or under 6 minutes, I should say, to play in the ball game. Davey lobs it out. Banks hit immediately and knocked down by Hester. Marvius Hester, sophomore out of Smyrna, Georgia.
He's 170 pounds. He wanted to get Tommy Banks before he got started. Now Georgia Tech needs to hold their ground right here to force the long field goal. This is a big football play here with a nice hit by Hester.
Here comes the crowd. The Tech folks to our left standing. To our right, the LSU faithful. They're standing. Here comes the blitz. Davey's pass is caught by Josh Reed for the first down.
Good combination.
Nick Rogers was all over the quarterback, and Davey got it to his favorite receiver for his ninth catch of the second half.
And there wasn't a lot of room to fit that football in. Rohan Davey under pressure again. He's going to get hit here just as he throws the football. Option route where Josh Reed just got to the sticks, turned around, open for the first down. Nick Rogers really leveling Rohan Davey.
So after that first down, just under 5 minutes, and now the clock continues to run. Points right here by LSU, and if they let another couple of minutes run off that clock, Georgia Tech's going to have to start calling timeouts. Safeties creep up. Tofio will go with a running play.
What did I say? Top 15 next year for LSU. Move them up to top 10. All these guys back next year?
Well, they lose on offense Williams and Whitey. I know that Royal is listed as a senior, but he was a prop kid, and his quality has done the required classroom work that he needs to do. He gets one more year, so he is back. So those are the players, along with Tommy Banks on offense and only Fred Booker on defense. Tofio breaks it big. 10-5, first and goal, LSU. 17 yards.
Everything down inside.
You can see DiMaggio pushing his man all the way back inside as well.
Lewis Williams, another good block. The offensive line for LSU. Rick Trickett, good adjustments at halftime. They've taken over this football game.
Like, this may be as big a flip as far as the fortunes of two teams from one half to the others I've ever seen. Look at this, 258 to 30 yards in the second half.
Remember, LSU had 7 yards rushing in the first half.
Straight ahead, Tommy Banks. He will have a couple of yards. And I have a feeling, if it is possible, that they would like to see the senior Tommy Banks, who has been such a hard worker, take the ball into the end zone. Georgia Tech uses one of those timeouts and will use it with him. 3:16 left in the ballgame. LSU driving again.
Coverage of the Australian Open begins January 14th on ESPN2.
Made from genuine cowhide bone and foot. Get a free Cows and Sports calendar containing $30 worth of food. Visit ChickfilAPeachBowl.com by midnight tonight.
Still in the news, the Buick year-end sell-off continues unabated. When Buick issued an additional $500 holiday bonus on select 2001 models, bringing total cashback offers up to $1,500, analysts predicted an immediate spike in market activity. Now, eager buyers are still storming the floor with no sign of a slowdown. You have to wonder, though, with holiday bonus cash ending January 2nd, how long can these market conditions last?
Hey, Bob.
Morning.
When you have a cold, even small tasks are a big pain. So get back your focus. Get DayQuil, the daytime non-drowsy, congested, stuffy head, sore throat, coughing, aching, fever, so you can get back your day medicine from the makers of NyQuil. Good move.
LSU 20-14 to show you it's a friendly crowd. This gentleman right here didn't have a pom-pom, so this attractive young lady comes down and says, you can have mine.
Save this.
And so watch this. See what happens when you get a pom-pom in your hand?
He's got some rhythm, too. But he tires. That's the only thing. He tired after a while, and he switched hands.
Heading back to the couch. 13th play of the drive started at their own 9-yard line. Play action. There's Banks. Touchdown for the senior.
That's a great effort by Rohan Davey again.
LSU to go for two from the shotgun. They roll the pocket in the end zone. Got the two, Reggie Robinson.
Rohan says it's easy.
Mike, I'm serious. As long as I've been watching football, I'm not sure I've ever seen two halves of football as opposite.
No.
I mean, Georgia Tech dominated in the first half.
They dominated. They came out in the second half. Rohan Davey gave them a spark on offense and defense and special teams. Brandon Winey can't kind of contain Greg Gather. Here's the touchdown. A little lofted. Tommy Banks, you talked about Tommy Banks getting the touchdown. He's a senior.
And the reaction, you could tell his teammates respect him, and they want to praise him for all his hard work for his years at LSU. All the guys that came over and gave him a hug when the play was over. And here's the two-pointer to Reggie Robinson. Now, how about this drive? 13 plays, 91 yards, 7:05 off the clock. Later tonight, ESPN's Capital One Bowl Week continues with the Culligan Holiday Bowl from San Diego at 8:30 Eastern. Chris Sims leads number 12 Texas against quarterback Joey Harrington and number 11 Oregon out in San Diego. For more, log on to ESPN.com, your home for college football on the Internet. That game is coming up next.
LSU fans have been loud throughout this football game. They have really done a good job for their players.
Here's a stat for you. Reed's 9 catches, all in the second half. Ties an LSU bowl record with Andy Hamilton in 71, the Orange Bowl game against Nebraska, and Wendell Davis in 87, the Gator Bowl game against South Carolina. Kick off into the end zone, and Hatch fumbles that one out of bounds. I'm not sure they wanted to return it and burn time off the clock anyway.
We've done some great ball games. The Fiesta Bowl, I think John Junker and his group do a great job. Gary Stokin and this group right here, they were the third best attended bowl game last year. And they record crowd in here again. They are doing things right in Atlanta.
Well, another record as far as the crowd that came in here to see this one. Yancey's pass is caught. That was a nice job of adjustment right there as the ball was a little bit behind Kerry Watkins and he had to pay for it. It was Damian James who handed out the punishment. Mike, when you have a situation like what has happened with LSU in this bowl game here, this pass incomplete, almost intercepted, and it was. It was tipped. Nope, they say he trapped it. He trapped it. Just to continue my point, this is the kind of situation where the coaches and even the players can't wait to get to spring practice.
No.
Because they know all these same faces are going to be there again.
Here's the other thing, Ron. It'll help in recruiting because you won. You won on national TV. You showed you came out in the second half with heart. And so you won. You're going to help in recruiting. You're going to go into spring practice feeling good about yourself. Got all these guys back, and you can't wait for the fall.
Gotcha. Quick pass. Got it complete. That's enough for the first down. Kelly Campbell.
You know, when you talk about their schedule next year in 2001, LSU, they open up with three home games. Tulane, which is not going to be an easy game. Chris Cephalo's doing a good job there. Utah State, Auburn, and Baton Rouge. Then they get open date. They'll handle them. Then they go to Tennessee to play the University of Tennessee. So they've got a good schedule next year. Get a chance to start with three home games.
Glover has that one complete up around midfield. Good for 18 yards. And Godsey still working hard and chipping away.
Seven home games for LSU next year, so should have another great year. And you got to give Jerry DiNardo some credit because this is the team he left.
Godsey's pass threw it a little bit low, and in order to catch it, Campbell made the reception, but he fell down, and they'll go with no huddle again.
All the coaching changes, Ron. You know the strangest one? Georgia.
Yeah.
I do not understand that. Never understand it.
very, very good job over there.
Glover makes another reception. Ball is loose at Battleford at the 34, and Tech has made a recovery. Joe Burns is the man who got on the football. Well, Ralph Friedgen, the new head coach at Maryland, the former offensive coordinator with Georgia Tech, looks on and kind of a lonely feeling there, unable to coach in this game. And offensively, six turnovers for the Yellow Jackets. It's hard to win when you got that many.
I thought Bill O'Brien did a good job. I just don't think they executed to the style that they're used to here. They too many turnovers. When Adrian interviewed Ralph Friedgen, he talked about, if you don't take care of the ball, you lose. And that every coach knows that. So Bill O'Brien did a very good job in his first game here. Just unfortunate that they had the turnovers. But credit LSU for forcing them.
For the adjustments on both sides of the football by LSU. Devastatingly good in the second half. Gotti up the far sideline. Got a man open at the five. He makes the catch, and Campbell steps out of bounds at the 3.5 yard line. 31 yards.
If they can knock this in, Ron, then get the extra point. They still got two timeouts. They still got time, but they got to get a onside kick. This is a good catch right here.
So they place the ball down at the 4 yard line. Still 1:39 to play in our ball game. 28-14. A Tech trying to get a quick one right here. Here comes the blitz. Godsey threw it with his left hand. Put it in his left hand, and it was Trev Falk who was all over it.
I don't think he could have thrown it with his right. I mean, he had to switch it to his left. He may be hurt. I mean, his shoulder. This is unfortunate because George Godsey's had a great year. Stumbling. Yeah, he came down hard. Trev Falk.
Andy Hall, a redshirt freshman, is on the sideline with his chin strap lax tight. You can see his numbers, 4 of 16, 37 yards. From Shiraz, South Carolina. Holiday Bowl is coming up, the Culligan Holiday Bowl.
This young man has had a great year, George Godsey.
...8:42 Eastern time is what time the kickoff is scheduled at the Culligan Holiday Bowl. So for those of you waiting for that one, you haven't missed anything, and not going to. Here comes the blitz right up the middle again. Falk, pass, lob, fade out, nobody there. Receiver fell down, and it was Jonathan Smith.
Very good coverage by Robert Davis.
Boy, this is now they're working on a knee. On a knee, so
that's just unfortunate. Again, turf, Ron, you talked about it. You pick your feet up, turf, it just very difficult to play on it when you haven't played on it before.
1:33 left to play in the ball game. Andy Hall, the quarterback. They blitz him again, and he's going to be hit behind the line of scrimmage, and it's going to be tackled back at the 10-yard line. Brady James making the tackle. Timeout taken by Georgia Tech, and we'll take it with them. 1:21 left in the ball game, and it's LSU 28-14. We'll be right back.
Okay, guys, enough with the ghost already. There's still time. Now your family can share 1,300 minutes for just $29.99 a month.
Time is back in. It's fourth down. Andy Hall. Play action. Looks for the end zone. Lobs it, and it's just a little too far. LSU holds. Nate Curry, the man that the pass was intended for, and George Gotze can only look on the sideline and what if. Boy, what a season the young guy has had. And to have it in, driving his team down the field and about to score and an opportunity to possibly get an onside kick and stay in it. Yeah. Well, the voting is complete. Tonight's Capital One Player of the Game, as selected by you, the fans at home at ESPN.com, is Rohan Davey. 17 of 25, 174 yards, three touchdowns, and 66% of the votes on ESPN.com for Rohan Davey. He will take a knee. The clock now runs at 110 and 109. Nick Saban also breaks a personal string, gets a win in a bowl game. And I'm not sure at halftime, when he went to the locker room, I'm not so sure that he was sure he was going to get his first.
No, but I think they made two big moves. Brandon Winey playing in the second half and handling Gather, and then Rohan Davey just sparked his football team.
The coach is being posted right here. He doesn't realize it, but they're setting the screen so that the old Gatorade bottle can come over, and here it comes. He's trying to run away, and he couldn't make it.
Mr. Zero.
He turns to the policeman and says, "Where were you?" And the policeman very wisely says, "I was not going to try to counter those brutes."
There's our fan. He's not waving anymore.
That wrist is tired.
Yeah.
12 seconds down to 11. He's working it again. Yeah. The LSU Tigers are about to win the 2000 edition of the Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl in a come-from-behind like this bowl game may have never seen. LSU 28, Georgia Tech 14. Coming up next, the Colligan Holiday Bowl from San Diego. For Mike Godfrey, Adrian Carson, and our entire ESPN crew, I'm Ron Franklin. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com, your home for college football on the Internet. So LSU wins here in Atlanta. Now the Colligan Holiday Bowl from San Diego.
Welcome to Capital One's presentation of the ESPN Bowl Week.
Great opportunity, man. Great opportunity.
Bogus! Bogus! Bogus!
Last chance of the season to excel and reach past the obstacles to lay it all on the line. Tonight, it's one of the legendary powerhouses in college football. The Texas Longhorns, loaded with playmakers all over the field, versus the Oregon Ducks, co-champions of the Pac-10, who could make history.